And we're live.
So I found this on Illegal Life Pro Tips, and the guy's asking for advice. I'm on parole, and I'm staying in a transitional house. There's a dude who lives with me who has 21 counts of sodomy sexual assault on 9 and 11-year-old kids. What do I do? I want to add, I'm not trying to go back to prison. I've got a family in another state. I'm trying to transfer there. I just can't beat the sick bastard to hell, and I'm on thin ice with my parole officer about targeting child molesters in the halfway house I was originally paroled to. That's why I'm not there. I can't just let it go, however, because what if this was your kid it happened to? And someone was asking what to do to the SOB who did it. I don't know. I don't want to be pro a 21 count sodomy sexual assault dude, but this guy's making some bad decisions. He's been kicked out of one halfway house already. He's not trying to go back to prison, but he's asking for advice on what to do to this person.
Yeah, you don't do anything. Like, what do you, Judge Dredd? Like, I mean, you're not even a regular civilian anymore. Like, I'm in a similar situation. You walk the line, dummy. That's what you do. My neighbor could be fucking Saddam Hussein hiding out, and I wouldn't do a goddamn thing.
No.
I'll do nothing.
No, yeah, exactly. Do absolutely nothing. Don't get in some weird vengeance cyclone where you start killing everyone, right? This seems like the fantasy of someone more than a guy who's actually in there.
You always like I'm gonna be, and you might be right. Yeah.
I mean, it's more right than wrong on Reddit.
I'll never even consider that angle until you bring it up. I like Kyle's accusation that he sees himself as Judge Dredd. I've talked about this before. I once interviewed for a job, and the guy who was interviewing me liked to volunteer at prisons. And what he taught was decision-making skills. He's like, you know, it turns out the reason they're in there is because they have bad decision-making skills. So I help them, you know, decide. They're just like, hey, here's a choice I might be making that will obviously have hugely negative ramifications. Let's not make that choice next time. And I feel like that's not a fit. There's like this elephant in the room. It's not just what Kyle was doing. But like, I don't know. There's a fight you could walk away from or engage in. Make smart choices. There's a person who slighted you. You could escalate or laugh it off. Like, make smart choices. And that's what he taught. This guy needs that lesson. This guy, what do I do? There's a person here who's sexual assaulter.
So what did this guy do? He said
he went to Reddit to ask, what should I do to this guy? Like, how do I get this guy without getting in trouble?
And the guy he hates raped a bunch of kids on 9/11?
The kids were 9 and 11.
He had a very, very strict window.
I imagine that it was like, I'm projecting all this, but 21 counts of sodomy, sexual assault on 9/11-year-old kids. Is it like a two brothers, two sisters, or a mix? And it was just 21 counts of the same two kids. That's my thought.
Maybe.
Probably.
I don't know.
But if he got nailed for 21 counts, that means there's probably like 80 counts that he actually did.
They just run up a bunch of counts. Like, it was 2 days, but he did 21 things over those 2 days. Right boob, left boob, upstairs, downstairs.
Now, I don't have a problem. In her mouth? Have a problem with like the judge doing like Magic the Gathering combos on pedophiles, where he's like, and now I'm in my recurring loop. You're in prison forever.
Right?
Oh, no.
That's how I think it is in my head. I don't know. Maybe you're right. Maybe he has a long list of very specific 9/11-year-old. What are you, 10? It's your lucky day, Dick.
Yeah. I watched a video of a judge. I watched a video of a judge sentencing a guy for child molestation the other day. He was working at a daycare, and she fucking like tears this guy a new one about how evil and awful he is. And then she's like, and you will be serving the maximum sentence of 20 years per offense. And sir, you will be serving them consecutively. It's just like, oh, they don't usually do that. They usually they do them concurrently. So you do them, you know, you get 20 years for this, 5 years for this, 10 years for this, but they all happen at the same time. So it's 20 years, you know, whatever whatever you got sentenced the most for, that's your end date. No, she's like one after another, your third sentence doesn't even begin until the year 2037, sir. It's just,
so he's gonna die in prison.
Yeah, because he was like 52.
Okay.
Oh yeah. So he won't even see, you know, he'll get like you know, through a molestation, like a fingering charge, and like all the rest is just going to be laying out there because he'll die.
And he's got to survive in prison.
Oh, he's way before. He's a 50-something-year-old man, probably looks like a pedophile.
Does not look like a strong guy. He looks, you know, just not going to go well for him.
Maybe he'll go to the right prison, right, with all the other pedophiles.
Maybe, maybe.
I don't know. Only Use Me Blade told that story where he's like, there was a great prison, you know, it was for child molesters, but I picked it because it seemed like it had a better viewer. I forget.
That's where I'd go too. If I might, if they had been like, all right, Kyle, you can go to the federal prison camp in Alabama, or you can go to the kitty diddler camp over in South Carolina. I'd be like, they got chili over there?
Hey, Kyle. Yeah, just a bunch of fucking kitty diddlers hanging out.
Yeah.
A good way to eliminate gang violence, like racial gang violence, instead of like introduce a huge number of pedophiles into normal prison, and that way the Aryans, the black gangs, the Latinos, they're all going to band together in this movie I'm inventing and fight the pedophile scourge, right?
Oh, no.
And when the last pedophile is slain in the prison riot, they look around and they go, we're not so different, you and I. And then they have, you know, prison sex.
What happens is the pedophiles secretly become the most badass gang and start raping the Aryans and the Crips. Everybody else, they got numbers on everybody. You said you were going to introduce a large amount of these people. They'll come in with their charm and their toys and their cool stereos, hypothetically.
Come on, boys. We're going to go fuck those pedos up. Come on, get your shit. Yeah, come back in like all bloody. He's like, dude, I don't want to fucking talk about it ever. Man, that was fucking wild.
You have preparation age because I'm in a little pain.
Yeah. The thing is, the thing about that is they wouldn't band together because even with pedophiles, the racial lines in prison are the core of everything. So a black guy can't come mess with a white pedophile. A black guy can come to the whites and be like, hey, y'all got a pedophile over there you need to handle.
Mm-hmm.
But he can't go over there. Like a black guy can't hit the white guy without starting a real problem. So like you've got to handle your own garbage, as it were.
Seems that it works out then, right?
It would work out, absolutely. It has been working out for a long time if you consider prison murder working out.
Yeah, but you called him garbage, and that's offensive to pedophiles, Kyle. I'd like you to apologize.
I'm going to stand by it.
That's a brave stance.
Oh, how can you be so courageous and
brave? We hate pedophiles, and they're bad. I don't care who comes after. That's what we're going to start doing. Yeah. Just really over-the-top, agreeable statements.
Mm.
Being like, and you nail me to the cross for that, but I think kids should be able to eat.
I mean, if they're hungry, give them a little food.
If they're hungry, they should be provided food. Good food, not school food.
School food's the fucking worst.
It was awful.